Hey, beautiful people, how you guys doing today? I would like to show you and sharing with you how to cook a kabocha. This is a Japanese pumpkin. It's so easy to cook it. It's just, I already preheat the oven for 350. And then here, I'm starting a cut it. Like chop it up, not chop, you know, big chunk like this with the skin. You wash really good and scoop the seed out and cut this big. Line up in the baking dish and it's kind of like a little bit difficult to cut it. Just be careful. So here we go. Okay, gonna cut some more. This is a very, very delicious. Every time winter arrive, at least I cook this Japanese pumpkin, or you call it kabocha, whatever you like to call. Very often, at least I cook it this one twice a week. See, it's how difficult. It's hard. There we go. We just pop up like this. You don't have to be pretty to cut it. Just whatever easy for you to cut it. Nope. This is too big. Okay, and I have brown sugar here. This is about 1 cup of brown sugar. So I'm just gonna spread it all over the pumpkin, all over kabocha. And then ground cinnamon. Okay. This is, and with anything tastes good with the pumpkin, go well with the pumpkin. What they call it, brown sugar and pumpkin and cinnamon. It just perfectly match. So, and then I put some butter. This is about 2 tablespoon butter. Probably about 1 tablespoon butter. 1 and a half. Okay. Line up some more. Just gonna pour all over the sugar to the pumpkin, all of them. And then ground cinnamon powder. Okay. Let me wash my hand. All right, that's it. I'm going to put it in the oven on copper, so do not cover up with oil or anything. Just like this, and you bake it at least for half an hour. So, thank you for watching my video. Bye, I'll see you in the next video.